New Hope TV, your encounter with God.
You have to pray, but with the word of God. Praising, praising, praising. Oh, she went, and you know what happened? She was refused, rejected, refused, depressed, lonely, rejected. Oh, beloved, every time she returned, her friends would have said, don't go again. You can never get anything from this man. Don't go again. Try some other means. Try some plan C, plan D. No. She said, no, I have only one plan. A to Z is only A. A to Z, my plan is only A. Not C and D. My D plan is my A plan. My G plan is my A plan. My B plan is my A plan. So A to Z, I have 26 alphabets in my life. A, A, A. He is Alpha. And he is my Omega. Alpha is my Omega. Lift your hands to Jesus. There is none but Jesus. There is none but the Son of God for you and for me. That is prayer. She returned. They would have said, oh, you are wasting your time. You are not going to get anything. She went. When she returned, she repented. She didn't go with new words. She went with a new heart. How many of you are learning here today? She went with a new heart and a new spirit. Every time she was refused, rejected, thrown out. Don't say there is no God. No, don't say I have to do this, I have to do that. No, you have to do only one thing. I have to do only one thing. See God, if there be any still wicked way in my life. Psalm 139, verse 23. Psalm 51, verse number 5 and 6. My innermost being, God. Is it clean? My innermost being, is it clean? Is it honest? Is it pure? Repent. Repent when you return. When you are returned, no job, no money, no answer, no victory, nothing. Return. And ask God only one thing. Father, I'm going to go again. I'm going to come and ask you. With the Father, you have many chances. But with God, as God, you and I have only one chance. Thanks be to the blood of Jesus. We go to him, Father. Come again. I have come again, Father. Yes, my son. Father, I realize there are unconfessed, secret, subtle sins in me. Oh God, forgive me, God. Forgive me. Forgive me. I have forgiven them all, son. I don't even remember them. That is you, God. But this is me. Father will say, well done, my son. Enter into my joy. He wants you and me to search our hearts. Lord, I was not loving. I was not kind. I was not forgiving. I was not holy. I didn't prepare much for my promotion. I'm saying hard work, but I didn't prepare much for my promotion. I didn't allow the word of God to cleanse my life. John 15 verse 3. When you are refused, when you are rejected, when you feel there is no God, get to John 15 whole chapter. The third verse cleanses me and cleanses you. Second verse prunes me and prunes you. Oh, God, now I know. I was impatient. I was angry. I spilt out words. I was not honest. You or I. Oh, the blood. What to do? The blood speaks on your side. Hebrews 12, verse 24. Cleanses me. Early morning. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I will go now again. She was going again and again as a new person, not the same old person. Are we receiving today? You are praying, I am praying. You are asking, I am asking. We are the same people asking. There is no change in me. There is no high love. There is no high humility. There is no high honesty. Same person asking again, money, money, job, 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 visa, visa, visa. Oh, my darling child, when are you and I going to allow God create in me a clean heart, oh God? Whenever you go back to prayer again, don't go as the same person. Go as a new person. 2 Corinthians 5 verse 17. Ezekiel 36, 26. How many verses we are quoting to you? Psalm 51 verse 10. Create in me a clean heart. Oh, she went again and again and again. Every time repenting, going. And also, when she went, she was sure he was there. You must know God never leaves his throne until he sees you blessed in life. He's there, Jehovah Shammah. He's there. She knew he will never leave me nor forsake me. Matthew 12, verse 20. My God, my God. Matthew 12, verse 20. Until he brings victory into your life and my life, he will never break a bruised reed. The world can crush you. The world can bruise you. The world can betray you. The world can cheat you. Until you receive victory, he will never leave the throne. Lift your hands to Jesus. Do you want another alternative than Jesus? My darling children, I beg of you. He loves you. He loves you. Matthew 12, verse 20. He will never leave you. Matthew 12, 20. Until he sees you lifted up in life. You are broken. Psalm 145, verse number 14. Psalm 146, verse number 8. He is here today. Psalm 92. He is here today. He loves you. How did she go to him? Lord, I have repented. I have cleansed myself. I'm going to claim it now. Never, never. Don't bring that claim. You are a citizen. He has purchased it already for you. Your citizenship and mine are in heaven. So all heaven's blessings must be for us on this earth. He has purchased it. He came from heaven and purchased it for you and me by his blood. So when you go again, well, you must believe. She went again. She knew. This fellow, he could have taken a leave and gone to some other country. He's the owner of the country or the president or the king or the prime minister or whatever. He could have done whatever he wanted. He could have hidden himself from this woman. She had no money. She had no friend. She was a lonely woman, destitute woman, widow. He could have hidden himself from her. Why should she be there? Parallel to the truth. Matthew 12, verse 20. Hebrews 13, verse number 5. Matthew 28, verse number 20. Until you and I receive victory on this earth, he will never leave us nor forsake us. Lift your hands to him. She knew he was there. He could have hidden himself. That's why you can come to him in prayer. My loving children, how did she? This is the essence and the excellence of God's prayer that pleases the Father. She went to him and said, thank you for saving me. Jehovah Shammah, you are there. Yes, you are there for me, I know. Thank you for saving me. This is what she was going with thanksgiving every time. Thanksgiving, you have given another day for me. You have given another moment for me. You have given another new life for me. You have given another new chance for me. You have given another new era for me until rapture. I praise you and thank you. Get to prayer with praises and thanksgiving. That fellow would have been wondering, were you praising me? The bodyguards and the secretary would have asked, why are you praising him? He's refusing you every time. No, he is there. For me, he could have hidden himself. He could have gone somewhere else. He could have killed my life, destroyed me. He didn't do anything. He didn't touch me. He only said, come again. Come another day, I can't. That's all. That was for my good. Even though the defeated devil intended it to be bad, that it was delaying and delaying and delaying, you would have got frustrated with God. No. You are being prepared for your promotion. Are we coming from where we started? She said, it's for my good. I went back. I searched my heart. I repented. I called the blood. I cleansed myself with the word of God. I came back with thanksgiving and praises. I'm a better person now, God, by your blood, by your word. It's good for me. Genesis 50 verse 20. Genesis 50 verse 20. It's good for me that I am getting cleansed even though the answer has not come. I am being prepared even though the pressure is too much. Don't ever say that. You are being prepared for your promotion. You have done too little for God to give you too much. I have done too little for God to give me too much. Oh, he loves you. So the bodyguards and the secretary, he saved you. Yes, sir, you don't understand. I'm a helpless person. He is the only help, and for you and me, Jesus. And he saved me. He could have killed me. He could have destroyed me. He could have put me somewhere, banished me from this land if needed. He had all that authority. But he didn't do anything. He did no harm to me. Therefore, I thank him. Therefore, I praise him. The bodyguards and the secretary would have informed the big man, look, she's praising you, sir. What? Praising you? Praising me for what? You don't know the words she is using you, sir. That you spared her life yesterday, day before yesterday. You didn't harm her. She's telling all these things about me. Oh, God. I am not worthy to receive all this credit. Next time when she comes, bring all the papers. I will sign everything for her. When you go again and again, not asking, not asking, not asking, but praising and praising and praising for saving you by his blood and your eternity by his blood and your generation by his blood and his resurrection. What you asked will be given unto you. He signed all the papers. Why? She said her continual coming. Did you see that in your Bible? Her continual coming wearies me. You know one thing? It is your continuous praises and not your continual answers that bring victory into your life. Not continual asking. Your continual praising only brings you the victory into your life. He dwells in the midst of praises. Psalm 22 verse 3. Psalm 22 verse 3. Praise him. That is your prayer. If you're asking for others, oh my beloved, praise God. God, I stand for this person on behalf of this person. And I thank you as how you are a father to me, as how you are a provider to me, as how you are a savior to me. Be that, I thank you for that, God. I thank you. Don't claim, please. He's your father. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. It's not the multitudes of your words and my words will bring the victory in your prayer. It's not the multitudes of your asking and my asking. Just one word of Jesus. And you know the word of Jesus. Praise. Praise. I praise you, Lord. I praise you. That is my prayer.
Going to pray with you right now. Loving Father, I humble myself before your people and you, my God, my Father. To you we come in the name of Jesus Christ, thy only begotten Son, whom you raised from the dead and today made him sit at your right hand side, Father. And in Jesus' name, all power in heaven and earth and over the defeated hell is given. Loving Father, I don't come on my own merit. I have no merit, God. Only the blood of Jesus Christ. Only the blood of Jesus Christ. I come to you. I humbly ask you, let all the sicknesses go away. Let all the physical ailments go away. Even the defeated symptoms and the causes of the diseases go away. Jesus, let the blind see now, God. Jesus, let the deaf hear now, God. Jesus, let the dumb speak now, God. Jesus, let the lame rise now and walk, God. Even let the dead rise now, God. Jesus, with you all things are possible. Wipe the tears of anyone, God. I thank you. I have told them that you will wipe their tears today. Loving Lord, loving Lord. Hebrews 5 verse 7, Luke 7 verse 13. Wipe the tears of everyone, God. Isaiah 25 verse 8. Wipe the tears of everyone, my Father. Heal all their diseases, Lord Jesus. Remove every burden of their life, Lord. Let them all rise up. Walk, live, rejoice, and praise you, and thank you, and always give you the glory. I thank you for this, Father. I thank you for this, Lord Jesus. I thank you for this, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, Father. Amen, 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 amen.